I thought that we had a deal.
Yes, we had a deal, and the deal was that I stay on this ranch and I work on my music with you until I'm 18. But I'm 18 now, remember? Or did you forget last night?
No, I didn't forget last night. But I also remember you saying something about you might consider hanging around if you and I got closer.
I said if we were lovers. Now, what are you saying? Are you saying you'll be my lover, Ted?
Wait, what kind of a question is that? I mean, it's just something. Can't make a deal about that. I can't turn my feelings on
well,
and off
I
like that.
Well, I don't have to. Mine are already on. It's you.
Come on, Elena. Come on. We've been through this before. I care about you. I care a lot about you. That's why I figure if we hang around, we work more on your singing. Maybe in time.
Oh, in time, maybe. When you grow up. I've heard enough of that stuff from Max to know that it's just a game, Jeb. You both hope that if I sit here on the ranch long enough, I'll forget what it is that I want out of life.
No, I'm not Max, and I'm not stupid enough to figure that you're going to give up singing like that. All I'm saying is, for you to sing, you got to learn how to sing. And for you to love, you just got to grow up a little bit.
Grow up?
Grow up!
No, thanks. I don't ever want to grow up. Not if it means that I'm going to be some kind of dull, lifeless bookworm. Somebody who dissects people like they were frogs. Yes, I am talking about your precious Courtney Marshall. I don't want to dissect my life. I want to live it.
All right, I agree
with
that.
All right, and I want to live it now, and I want to feel it. And if you don't want to share that with me, well, I will find somebody else who wants to. Oh, excuse me, I've got places to go.
Wait a minute, where are you going?
I am going to get out of these old clothes and put on something that I can audition in.
Audition for what?
For that job in the chicken coop. Billy Joe said he could fix me up. So I don't need you. I can go it alone.
When I talked to Iris, she agreed to call Elliot. She'll ask him to visit her at Gulf Coast. That way we'll be able to surprise him in the hall. They're at, you haven't changed your mind, have you?
I was just thinking, it's like an ambush. Use the element of surprise on your enemy and cut him down. Thought I was through with all that.
Look, I'm sorry, Barrett. I wish there were some other way to handle Elliot, but, okay, look. If you want, I'll call it off. We'll find another way, all right?
No. I owe those men who followed me. I'll go through with it, but I don't want Ginny involved. I don't want her to know.
No, of course not. Don't worry about that.
Right? Oh, sorry to interrupt, but Ginny's here for Barrett. Should I send her in?
Of course.
Thanks, Terry.
You all right?
Could we go home, please, Barrett?
Well, I'd like to, but... Ginny!
Oh.
Get her to the sofa, quick.
Here, I'll get her. Sit down here, Ginny.
All right.
No, please, sit down.
I'm fine. Fine, really.
You okay? You nearly fainted.
I know. Okay.
I'm sorry, Barrett. I didn't...
No, don't apologize. I'm glad Ginny had people to take care of her while I was gone. Darling, what'd the doctor say?
You saw a doctor? You're not ill, are you?
Will you... Both of you, stop this. Now, all this fussing over me. You'd think something was terribly wrong with me the way you're carrying on.
There isn't, is there?
No. Bart said that there's no reason to be alarmed about anything. So can we go home, please?
Darling, I promised Ryan that we'd stay in Houston. I've got to make an appointment at 6 o'clock.
6 o'clock? That's hours from now.
Look, Barrett, I have a company helicopter available now. I can have it fly Ginny back to the ranch, all right?
Think Grandma would mind having a helicopter land in her backyard?
She's used to it by now.
Oh?
Yeah, I've made some business trips out to the ranch.
Oh, that's right. You told me. Well, Ginny?
No, that's all right. Ryan, I really don't want to put you out. If I could just stay here and rest a while, I'll wait for you.
Sure, I just wish, I wish I could have you flown back to the ranch. You look pale.
You look pale, Ginny. Did the doctor tell you anything? What is it?
It's just nerves. Just nerves, that's all. I am... So many things happening. I'm just having trouble adjusting. That's all.
Barrett asked me this morning to make him a sweet potato pie. First time he's shown any interest in food. It's a sure sign that he's getting his spirits back. It's more than I can say about you. What's wrong?
It's Elena.
Oh? Well, that girl's been a worry to us all. But I guess that's always true of their youngest. Maybe it's just that there are too many older folks fretting about her.
Well, no, ma'am, I think it's more to it than that.
Well, I don't think so. She was raised right. She's a Decker. Good blood and good upbringing will pay off in the end.
Oh, well, I don't know about that. I don't know whether my father will agree with you on that one. Consider it the way I turned out.
Well, I think you're just being too hard on your father and on yourself. Of course, my granddaughter Paige is no credit to the Marshall line. But then Elena isn't conniving like Paige. She's just restless like you. You know, all that pacing is making me nervous.
Well, I always do this when I think.
Well, come on over here and help me peel potatoes. That ought to settle you down.
Okay.
I guess Elena's just got to work off a little steam, that's all. She'll come to her senses. She'll soon get over this fool notion of being a big star.
Yeah, well, that's if this fool notion don't kill her first.
Well, how could singing kill anybody?
Well, Miss Marshall, ma'am, I don't mean to be impolite, but you don't know what's going on out there.
Well, I don't think the world or the people in it have changed that much since I was Elena's age.
Well, no, I'm not talking about here. I'm talking about the music business. It's crazy. It's all weird. And that craziness, well, that can kill you.
Oh, Jeb, now aren't you exaggerating?
No, ma'am, I am not. I was in it for 3 years, and I had a friend that was a lot like Elena. She even looked like Elena, and she wanted to be a star, too, just like Elena. And the circuit, drugs, and... Well, it killed her.
That explains it.
Explains what?
All the time you've spent helping Elena, protecting her. When you feel about Courtney the way you do.
Well, okay, now I know you're still mad at me for that, for breaking up the wedding like
no,
that.
No. No, I'm grateful to you for that. It's just that I don't approve of your methods. But you did save Courtney from a marriage to a man who could never have made her happy, no matter how much he tried.
You think she's happy now?
Well, I think she's got a better shot at it. What about you? Now, you've been dragging around here for the last couple of weeks. Now that Courtney's free, can't you make up your mind which one of them you want?
No, it's not that. It's just that Courtney went to town, and I can't even talk to her anymore.
Hey,
Elena's...
I won't be home for supper. I'm catching the bus in Houston.
Can that happen? Child, you don't even look like yourself.
Well, if you mean that I don't look like a good little schoolgirl, well, that's great, because I'm going into town to audition for a singing job. And this is what successful singers look like.
Well, I don't know about that. The only person I knew that dressed like that, I wouldn't call her successful.
Well, I heard she cut a few records. And she had 1 million fans. And everybody knew who she was.
The singer. Is that the girl you were talking about, Jeb?
Yes, ma'am, it is. And like I said, she had to move real fast and she burned herself out. Is that what you want to do? Is that what you want to waste yourself like that? Where you got no body, you got no soul, all you got is a voice singing the blues?
No, but I won't let that happen. No blues for me. I want upbeat country music. And I want to make people happy.
That's why I'm trying to tell you.
And I want to make myself happy.
Well, you're not going to make anybody happy. You go around imitating someone.
Yeah? Well, maybe I can learn from her mistakes then. Like knowing not to expect anything from you. Goodbye, Jeff.
Goodbye.
Elena. You're not going into Houston on the bus alone at night.
Well, sure I am. Why not?
If you let me borrow your car again, I will make sure that she gets to town safely and she will get home safely. Thank you.
No, of course, Iris. I'm glad you called. Oh, you're not interrupting my work. Family's more important. Yes, I think I can be there by 6. You'll be finished dinner by then? No, on the contrary. No, you've pleased me very much. Yes, well, I'll see you soon.
Mm-hmm. I'm sorry, Elliot. I couldn't help over here. Are you going to see Iris?
Yes, she's in the hospital having some tests run.
Nothing serious, I hope?
Oh, I don't know. She hasn't gotten the results yet. I trust it's just a false alarm, but at any rate, she's lonely. She wants me to keep her company.
Well, I've just finished some of the preliminary research on that series that Vicky wanted us to do.
Oh, I hope you don't want to talk about that now. I told Iris Hadmedia I'd come to the hospital.
Well, no, not at this moment. There are one or two points I would like to discuss with you on the way to Gulf Coast.
You're going there, too? Oh, I see. You want to talk to Iris, is that it?
Yes. To tell Iris that the DA has dropped all charges against me. To tell her how much I regret what happened to Alex. I think it'll be a little easier for me to face her if I come with someone that she trusts.
Yes, Iris can be formidable, but if you're worried about a tirade, don't be. She knows you've been cleared.
Good. Then she does believe me. She believes I'm innocent.
Well, I couldn't say. But Iris can surprise you, even when you know. She no longer talks of revenge. I think she's come to accept Weaver's death.
I'd still like to go with you. To assure her that I didn't have anything to do with Alex's murder.
Well, I had planned to see her alone.
I know you two have a lot to talk about. Your son, his engagement to my sister. I promise I won't stay long.
It means a lot to you, doesn't it? Iris's opinion of you.
I wronged her husband. I blamed him for my father's death. I suppose you could put it this way. If I can't ask Alex Wheeler for his forgiveness, then I must ask Iris for hers.
Understanding and forgiveness. It's what we all want, isn't it? I wouldn't deny that to any man now. Come along if you like.
There. Maybe that'll help. Are you sure you don't want to go in the suite and lie down on the bed?
No, really, I'm fine, Terry. I just wish I hadn't said anything. Barrett and Ryan made such a big fuss about this.
Look, Jenny, I know you didn't want to go in the helicopter because it might look like you were too close to Ryan. But it's the quickest way back, and you wouldn't have to fight rush hour traffic. I'll tell Barrett you changed your mind.
No. Terry, please. The thought of going up in that helicopter just makes my head whirl.
Oh?
I guess it's nerves. My stomach's upset. I feel dizzy. I don't know.
Just tension, that's all. What you need to do is relax. Get yourself a good neck rub. That's what I used to do for Alex.
You really miss him, don't you?
Yes. Never realized how much a part of my life he was. Still find myself making mental notes. Get this to Alex's attention. Make a fuller report on that.
I did that with Barrett. for the longest time.
You haven't told him yet, have you, about you and Ryan being engaged?
No, I haven't had the courage to.
Ginny, I think you're very courageous.
Oh, no. No, I am a terrible coward. I can't seem to face anything. Every word, every look is a lie. When Barrett turns his back, I think he'll find out. And when he has to face me again, he'll hate
me. Ginny, don't feel like that. You don't deserve to feel like that.
I can't help feeling it. And I don't know what to do either. It's almost as if Barry and I have changed places. He's home, and I'm in some limbo somewhere. Where I can see everyone, but I can't touch them. And I cry out, but no one hears me.
I hear. Ginny, nobody blames you. We all think you're good and brave for going back to Barrett, loving him. I know it must be hard, but there's no turning back now, is there?
Well, Ginny, your suspicions were correct.
No, there is no turning back.
Set up the ambush.
Well, if that's how you want to put it. Look, this is Iris's room. Elliot has to be coming down this hallway.
And into our trap. Antiseptic hospital hall. Some comfortable overstuffed chairs. It's not much like the jungle.
Look, Barrett, Elliot's a very civilized man. Now, the jungle wasn't his element. This is.
But the tactics are the same.
I'm sure if he suspected anything, he wouldn't buy this. But right now he's off guard. He thinks he's on top of things, so now's the time to strike, all right?
Let's hope so. And tell me what you want me to do.
Look, Barrett, I don't want you to do anything. I just want you to sit down right over here. All I want is for Elliot to see you. I just want him to react. Hopefully it'll throw him so far off he'll make a mistake, a fatal one. I'm going to be right behind you. Let's see, it's almost six. Elliot should be here any moment. Now, when he does come, you just stay seated. Don't react, all right? Okay. Oh, hello, Elliot. Justin? Well, nothing's wrong with the Marshalls. I just saw Ginny a little while ago. They're not sick.
No, everybody's fine.
Well, we just came to see Iris.
Oh, you too, Justin?
Yes, I wanted to see Iris, too. I owe her something.
I see.
How is Iris? You've just been with her, I presume.
Well, no, as a matter of fact, I was just going to visit her. I've been seeing Barrett Marshall.
Barry's here?
Yeah, we've been trying to restore his memory. Bart Walker's been using sodium pentothal.
I thought that Barry felt that he didn't want to remember.
Well, he changed his mind. And now that his memory's starting to return, he's very glad he did. I guess he feels he has a lot of old debts he wants to see paid up.
Well, I want to see him before I leave. I don't get out to the ranch as often as I'd like.
Well, Barrett's sitting right over there. How about you, Elliot? Don't you want to see Barrett again?
Excuse me, Elliot.
What's the matter, Elliot? I thought you and Barrett were old friends. How long were you in that prison camp together, anyway? What, a year? I mean, that's long enough to get to know each other right down to the last detail now, isn't it? So go on. Go see him, Elliot. Or can't you face him again, huh?
Barry.
Hello,
Jess. They're not pushing you too hard, are they? You look done in.
As long as I got my family, nobody can push me too hard. You know that.
Yeah. Listen, there's somebody I'd like you to meet. I think you'll be able to remember him. You were in Cambodia together. Elliot Carrington and I... Where is Elliot?
I was right, Barrett. Elliot won't face you.
Face you? Barry, what is this?
An ambush. Bringing the jungle to Houston. Making the past alive again. So it can die again.
So we were right. Elliot must have betrayed you and the others. He couldn't even think of an excuse to leave. He even forgot about Iris. Nothing mattered to him but just getting away.
Just a minute, Connor. Are you saying that Elliot Carrington had something to do with Barry getting shot during the escape?
I'm saying a lot more than that. Now, Alex suspected Elliot's betrayal and threatened to expose him. Now, that's why Elliot shot Alex.
Elliot shot Alex?
Turning into a real city girl, aren't you? Well, coming here every night and...
I sure am. And I don't need permission from Max anymore. Well, I am 18 and I am legal.
Well, of course you don't. Boy, you are looking pretty grown up in that outfit. Even more so in that fancy dress you wore last night. Oh, boy, that was a fun party, wasn't it? It's a shame that y'all couldn't stay a little longer. But I guess you had some private celebrating to do, huh?
We sure did. Mm. Jeb and I went to the top of the world, and we looked out over all of Houston. And then Jeb took me home.
Yeah, that's right. I took her home, all right. My prize student, I didn't want her to strain her vocal. Well, you know that I manage her now. You know that, don't you, Nita?
Well, now, sure I do. But seeing you two together, I thought
that
maybe
thought
there was
something... No.
You know, Jeb is reminding me more of Max every day. When I pick a man for myself, he's going to have to be more exciting than that.
Oh, well.
Nita, would you please get me a beer?
Would you get me one, too, please?
Absolutely.
Don't you think maybe you ought to eat something first? Elaine, if you're going to be singing, you want to be able to stand up?
Oh, you singing at a party or something?
No, I got a lead on a singing job last night, so Jeb and I came in today to follow up on it. But the nightclub was closed, so we decided to come here and get something to eat first.
Oh, a singing job, huh? Where?
Oh, it's at a little place down the road. I don't think you've ever heard of it.
Of course she's heard of it. Her husband runs the place and works there.
Oh, it's the chicken coop, then.
That's right. Her husband is the one that offered you the job there.
Elena, honey, have you ever been to the chicken coop?
Well, I told you we went by there, but it was closed. Well, it looked like a nice little club from the outside.
Well, it's really not a club. It's a bar, and not a very nice one at that. I mean, it doesn't open till late. It doesn't close till dawn. Now, is that the kind of place that a nice girl like you wants to be singing at?
Well, I'll tell you what kind of place it is, Nita. It's the kind of place where I can get my start. Now, it isn't Nashville, and maybe it's not the top of the world.
Bottom of the world could be.
Okay, so maybe it is. I don't plan on staying there forever. I mean, not everyone has to work at the same dull, boring job year after year just because you do, Nita.
You know, Maggie's is a real nice place to work. I'm real happy working here.
Are you?
Yeah,
Marley Matt.
You mean you knew all the time that Elliot Carrington shot Alex and you let me sit in that jail, put my family through that agony?
Oh, wait a minute, Justin. I suspected Elliot shot Alex, but I didn't have any proof.
Why didn't you tell some of your suspicions to the police? Take a little of the heat off me.
There were some very compelling reasons not to, Justin.
Were they compelling enough to let me go to trial, or were you waiting for me to get death row?
Just calm down. Listen to the man. I think he's playing straight with you.
All right, go ahead.
Look, Justin, from the moment Alex was shot, I suspected Elliot did it, but nothing more. I mean, for all I knew, it could have been you who pulled the trigger.
All right, how's Barry fit into all this?
Okay. Now, Alex had some information that Elliot might have been the one who betrayed his fellow prisoners. I was checking up on the rumor when I found Barrett.
And Ryan got me sent home, Just. Don't forget that.
Yeah, I'm very thankful to you for that, Connor. But now that Barrett's memory is returning, I think you should go right out and pick up Elliot Carrington. If you can't prove that he shot Alex, then you should be able to prove that he was responsible for the deaths of those prisoners.
No, I'm afraid we can't. My memory isn't coming back.
I told Elliot that Barrett's memory was returning just to see his reaction, that's all.
You're playing a very dangerous game here with my brother. Elliot killed a man. If he did to keep the truth hidden, what do you think he's going to do to Barrett? Barry, I don't like this. I think you should get out.
No. If Carrington betrayed the escape, then I have a duty to the men he killed, to the people who love them, to myself.
All right, I guess I can understand that.
Okay, look, Justin, I'm going to need your help, too.
How?
I want you to keep your eye on Elliot. Now, you work with him. If it looks like he's ever going over the edge, you'll be able to spot it first and then warn us.
All right. All right, I guess I can do that. I owe Alex that much.
Listen, there's one more thing both of you need to know.
Dr. Kenner, what is that?
It's Alex. He's alive.
What is this? He was shot. He died on the operating table.
Alex was shot, all right, but he didn't die. Now listen to me. Elliot was getting too close to Iris. Now, I couldn't tell Iris that Alex had survived without Elliot finding out. So I had to make them both think that Alex was dead.
Alex is alive?
Alex is alive. On his yacht. And by tomorrow morning, he'll be back in Houston. Can't you face him?
Oh, please! Go away and leave me alone!
If I'm dead, what will they tell you? That your father was a murderer. That he was responsible for the death of a dozen men you never knew in a place you never heard of. That your father killed the man who sired you in a moment of blind lust. The man who raised you, who loved you, had no more to do with your paternity than a stranger who passes by, unseen, unheard, unloved. No. No, I can't let that happen. I won't. I have to put an end to this forever.
Say that, darling, because it's pretty little ladies like you that we aim to please.
Thank you.
And we start with drinks on the house. For both of you, good luck.
Hi, Bernie.
Nita, how you doing? I didn't even see you over there.
Well, it's kind of dark in here.
Hey, I'm real glad you came back. So, you like my place okay, huh?
Yeah, well, it's real busy.
This crowd? Oh, this ain't nothing. The place don't really start jumping till after midnight. That's why I hired Billy Joe to come here after that swanky place shuts down.
I see he's not here yet.
Oh, but he's coming in early tonight. Don't worry. He'll be in any minute. And while we're waiting, I'll set you two up at a real good table right near the band.
Great, Ryan. Thank you.
Okay, well, what'll you drink?
A beer.
Can I have one too, please?
You got it. All right. And how about you, Nita? Anything you want, free of charge.
Well, I'm not drinking any alcohol, no baby.
Oh, that's right. I forgot. I'm sorry. You taking real good care of that little fella, are you?
Sure am.
That's good. You know, Nita, Billy Joe sure is lucky to have himself a good little wife like you. Okay, sit tight, everybody. I'll be back in a flash.
Hey, they're pretty good, don't you think?
Yeah, no, they're not bad. Not bad at all. Dump like this.
No, I think they're a little bit too loud.
Huh?
Yeah, they are. I wonder if I'm going to be able to sing with them.
Okay.
What's the matter? You look a little nervous. I told you you need more practice. Then you would be able to go up and you could sing anywhere you wanted. But no. You're ready for the big time.
That's right. I'm ready for the big time, and I'm not going to miss this chance either. Billy Joe said he could get me on here as a singer.
Hey, how we doing tonight there, Fishface?
Hey. All right, you old rattlesnake.
All right.
Hey, we got a surprise customer in here. Come on, take a look at this.
For me?
Yeah.
Somebody I know?
Oh, wait till you see.
Is she young?
Oh,
she's pretty.
She's beautiful.
Well, what are you two good-looking girls doing in here, huh? How you doing, darling? I thought you weren't going to be here anymore.
Well, Lena wanted to come. So
oh, yeah?
Have you forgotten you told me I can audition tonight, Billy Joe?
Oh, yeah, sure, of course not.
Band, huh? Well, what do you want me to do, Billy Joe?
I'll tell you what, honey. As soon as that band comes off its break, you just jump right up there and start singing your little heart out.
Without any rehearsal?
Well, sure. They're a good band. They can play most anything.
Yeah,
get
well,
up there.
I've never played with a band like that before. Jeb's always been my backup.
I'll tell you what. You just bring that guitar with you. Get on up there. You can play pretty good.
Jeb, you're better than I am. You do it.
Well, I don't feel like playing this banana spot.
Well, that's great. Why don't you just get out of here, Jeb? I don't need you. I can do it by myself. You are a big help, you know that?
You're right. I am better.
There is a household, and he's drunk. So mothers, tell your children not to do what I have done.
And two more out here. So I don't want you to budge from behind the bar. You hear me? You just ring up the cash receipts and things like that, and I will try to be back before the dinner hour.
I am going to be all right. Now you just stop worrying.
I am entitled to worry if I want to. Never catered a wedding this big in my whole life. And I never had my best friend of 3 years move out on me either.
Hey, I'm still going to be working here. It's not like I'm never going to be back.
No, you'll be back, probably in a stolen car or Lord only knows what.
Oh.
Now, never mind. I'm not going to lecture anymore about Billy Joe Wright.
Well, good.
For today. I got better things to think about. What are you doing with that suitcase? Now, put it down. Listen, women in your condition are not supposed to haul freight.
I am okay. It's not very heavy.
If that shiftless lump is going to make you move in with him, the least he can do is come and help you.
Well, he's sleeping now, and I don't blame him. He's working a second job, you know, tending bar, late shift at the chicken coop. You know, that place down the street.
No, that dive. Yeah, the two of them are made for each other.
Not a very nice place, is it? And the kind of people that go there, it's... In fact... Maggie, you know I'm the kind of person that doesn't pay no mind to other people's business.
Oh, honey, I know that. But now go on, tell me, because I am.
Well, thanks to Billy Joe. Oh, and I really do believe he thinks he's doing the girl a favor. But anyway, thanks to him. Elena is working there singing nights.
She what?
Mm-hmm. Auditioned yesterday. She didn't want to tell you because she knew you'd make a fuss.
Oh, Nita, do you think she's planning on getting mixed up again with you-know-who, the one I'm not lecturing about?
Well, she could do a lot worse working in that place. Now, you don't need to say that I said so, but I hope that you or Max, or Ricky, if he ever gets back, can talk her out of working at that place.
Did you... excuse me. Did you see Elliot come in this morning?
About tonight, killer.
Hmm?
What are you planning to wear to Rena's wedding?
Oh, what? Oh, I don't know. Suit. Why?
Oh, I don't know. I thought you just might wear the groom's boutonniere and the bride on your arm.
Sam, what is that supposed to mean?
Nothing.
I didn't show up last night, did I?
Let me think. No, you didn't.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Well, that's all right. I understand. You only live once, and some people don't even get a chance to do that. So if you'll excuse me.
I was really busy, but not with Rena.
Did I ask? Don't we have an agreement? No jealousy, no interrogations. Just live and let live.
Right, right, right. Mm-hmm.
The sexual revolution is over, and our side won, hands down, so to speak.
Oh, Sam.
So kindly get your face out of my office unless you want that chiseled profile embedded permanently in my door.
Sam. Sam, I said I was busy. It was just too important to drop.
An explanation? How passe. But since you insist upon being so old-fashioned, why don't you give me the whole story?
I can't.
I have work to do.
All right, wait. I was working on a story.
I hope it's better than the one you're trying to hand me.
All right. Now you're going to be quiet and listen. And anything I say, you have to promise, is not going to leave this room. You got it?
Got it.
Believe me, nobody could, but you could drag this story out of me.
Me?
Listen, I had a long talk with Ryan Connor. He wants me to help him trap the guy who really shot Wheeler.
You mean Billy Joe Wright?
No.
But I thought the police said that Curtis and...
No. Connor knows more than the police do. He's convinced me that the guy who really did it... it's Elliot Carrington.
But that's... No. Ryan said that?
Sam, think. Here, top of the World Club, while Curtis was laying his plans, Carrington was there listening to every word, turning Curtis's little scare into a murder attempt. Oh. It's true. What's wrong?
Attempt? No, you said it. Alex Wheeler is alive?
Seems we had Ricky, you could have piloted the Iris back home.
It's easy for you to say.
Well, that middle stretch was late.
Well done. Yeah. Oren, we've come back from St. Croix safe and sound and at full flank speed. Quite a trip.
All in a day's work, Mr. Wheeler.
More like a month altogether, wasn't it? I think you and your crew are due liberty. Enjoy it, huh?
Thank you, sir.
And as for you, Ricky...
Oh, no, Alex, you need me here.
Oh, you know, my luck is astounding, being surrounded by good and faithful...
Yeah, and stubborn people. At least I am, and I plan to stay.
Didn't Ryan send word that your brother was getting married? Don't you want to go?
But I don't think...
But nothing. Now, scram and have a good time. I'm not helpless anymore. I'm sound and up on my feet and...
Yeah, but, Alex, I don't know. I think, really, that I should stay here.
Am I gonna have to throw you out myself? Boot you out myself, huh? You want me to show you how healthy I am?
All right, I'll be back early, boss.
You too, and I'll clap you in Iris.
Maggie's by lunch.
Boarded.
By lunch and no later. Did you order this?
You got a hell of a way to come in the room, you know that? You lugged this thing the whole way?
Oh, honey, I'm sorry. The bus and everything. Good morning.
Morning.
Oh, you must be tired.
Hmm? You too. You should take a taxi. I keep on telling you.
No, I don't want to waste good money. Well, let's see. We got some more unpacking to do. Is this it?
Wait. Come here a second.
What?
Come on. Home is his palace, and that makes you a princess.
Huh? Oh, will you put me down before you drop me? Get me down.
Huh? I ain't pregnant. Look over here, darling. Now, really look at this, huh? Look what I got for you, huh? That's for you, darling. A whole dining room set. Chrome to match your hair. Gold and silver. Get it, huh?
Hey, honey, are these chairs extra? Because we just need two of them.
Hey, look over here, darling. What? Right in here, huh? Look what I got you. Oh. Right over here, I got you that big old bed, huh? A big old bed. Of course, look a lot better once we get all fixed up and stuff like that, you know. Come over here. Come over here. Look what I got over here.
Oh.
Now, look at this. Check out this couch, huh?
Oh.
Now, you tell me that ain't soft in the right place, huh? Soft, huh?
Oh, it's nice, Billy Joe. It's all real nice. Oh, but, honey, I bet it cost a lot.
Why not? You let blow it. I mean, this is for us, huh? You and me. I mean, I don't like furnished places. Do you? I mean, live around other people's stuff? We need some stuff for our own, just for you and me.
Oh, I know, honey, but all that money we had, it didn't go very far, did it? And we need towels, and we need dishes, and we need placemats, and baby
things.
So? And how about the baby?
Buy it. Anything you want, beautiful. Nothing too good for you and my little boy, or girl.
Oh, this Billy Joe? The chicken coop, right?
Bernie told me that place is a gold mine. I didn't believe him, but I do now.
Well, gold mine or no gold mine, it is no place for a girl like Elena, and you know that.
Elena? Sure it is. Wise her up a little.
Wising up can wait a few years.
Shoot, I don't want to talk about her, honey. We got plans to make. We got furniture to build, you know, we got more things we got to buy. We got this here couch to try out.
Well, what's this? No welcoming committee?
Ricky, you're back. Oh, honey, it's so good to see you. How are you? Were they feeding you all right?
Who?
Well, I don't know. Whoever's been feeding you. Now stand still and let me look at you.
Well, I'm all here. It's only been a month.
Yeah, plus another month when you just came by once in a while to carry your supper out. You know you've been gone longer than old Bill Bailey?
Yeah, maybe. Hey, where's Nita?
Oh, Nita.
She in back? Nita!
Ricky! She's not here. She moved out this morning.
Moved out? She wouldn't do that. Why? Where's she going to move to? She wouldn't move out.
Well, I don't know the name of it. She moved to, apartments.
Oh, not with him. I don't care as long as it's not with him. She did, didn't she? Well, damn it, Maggie, why'd you let her?
Let her? Now, you listen to me for a minute, Ricky Decker. I delivered myself of more hard advice to that girl than you and your brother and your sisters ever dreamed about getting in a lifetime. She just would not be changed.
But I don't get it. Why?
Well,
We promised her up and down he's reformed. And took a second job to help pay for her apartment. I don't know, I guess she believes him. Either that or she thinks, who knows the love of a good woman. Of course, what he really needs is the back of a good woman's hand.
Yeah, but the last time I heard, she was gonna stick with him through this murder charge, and then that was supposed to be it.
He has been holding that over her like a leash. That and telling her he's needing her.
Well, what about me? I need her.
Well, maybe you just ought to have told her that.
She knows.
Does she know? You know, you have not exactly been acting like a man with courting on his mind. She tried to find you, she asked people, tried to call you.
Yeah, well, I've been away. You know, it was business. Well, it wasn't my choice.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we were told that. But not by you. Billy Joe loves her. And she knows that. He does the best he can for her, which is not very good. I think it's up to us just not to butt in right now when she's liable to have troubles enough as it is. Ricky, however foolish it might seem to you and me, we have got to let her go her way.
I don't even mind waiting. I never did. But I guess maybe there's nothing to wait for anymore. Well, I'll leave her alone.
I think it's time you put something else on your mind, like family.
Oh, yeah, I'm going to be the best man at Max's wedding. Well, I mean, you know, you can't be the groom, I guess you can...
I'm talking about Elena and her new career.
Yes? Alex Wheeler is alive.
That's alive. You can't say again. Why? This is the ultimate stunt. Why this charade with the funeral and the manhunt?
His assassin had to think that he was dead. Connor told me that Alex went into a coma right after surgery. He would have been the perfect mark.
Oh. So Kevin Cook faked the papers.
That's right. Put him into a private hospital room under another name until he came to. As soon as he came to, they put him on his yacht and he sailed off to get his strength back.
Well, if he's all right now, why are they going on with this hoax? Well,
would you rather Carrington have another crack at it? No. Connor wants to get Carrington first.
Then why doesn't he go to the police? He's playing pretty fast and loose with the law here.
Listen, this has a lot of convolutions to it. Curtis and Wright were setting me up. Elliot was setting them up. I know it's going to be hard to prove all of this.
Well, I know. You can hardly convince me.
I think our best move is to try to unsettle Carrington's, his nerves. Try to play on his guilt a little bit. He's a smooth guy, I know, but there's a crack in that facade. I think I've seen it. And once he starts to feel the squeeze, he's going to run right into that net.
You know, that may be working already. He never showed up for work today.
I didn't come by last night. I said I would, but I didn't. I'm sorry. You can set it down with my other sins of omission. If there's room. They mount at every turn. They're numberless. Don't. you ever think that for every act committed, there are thousands left undone? Thousands! You can hear them howl. They're dying. The possibilities. My entering here, my closing the door is a death. Did you miss me?
I don't think you should stay just now.
Oh, Ben. You didn't. I look. How?
I missed you, yes, but it wasn't important. I don't think you should feel.
You should be in bed.
Elliot, what has happened?
You should be in bed. Here.
Well, there's no need, Elliot. I'm just here for tests.
Frightened?
Well, yes, a little.
Good. You know, sometimes I think, oh, not you, not Dennis, but the world at large doesn't take me seriously enough. People assume I'm like anyone else, people I don't know. Which, of course, I'm not. What was it Lenin called revolutionaries? Dead men on furloughs.
Do you want to?
Dead men are the most serious of all. Hell adheres to us. The stench of it. That's how we recognize each other. Did you see him too?
See? Who?
Barrett Marshall, did you?
I don't know him. No. He was in Cambodia with you, wasn't he?
He died there.
He was reported dead, just as you were.
A man in the safety and silence of his grave can be forgiven anything. But we who dare to come back have debts to pay, promises to keep, and miles to go before we sleep.
You feel you owe him something?
Is there any offense before God or man more heinous than betrayal? Come, tell me. You know. Say it!
I don't know. I suppose, yes.
No, there is not. It has murder in it, and jealousy, and deceit, and all the 100 guises of depravity. Brutus, Judas, those who sold their friends.
Why are you telling me this? What do you want? All right. How did you betray him?
It was he! He sold his soul for a few more stinking years among the living. As if he could ever enjoy a minute of it, knowing what he knows about himself. I know. I've said nothing. I know. Why should I? The Marshals seemed decent enough. Why should I tell them that their eldest was a brute, lying, treacherous, bloodthirsty butcher?
No, don't, please, Elliot. I'll call someone. You'll be all right.
Listen. I want you to know the kind of creature this man became. We planned the escape together. All of us. We'd stolen a gun. We knew that some of us would die. But It seemed worth the risk. But not to him. There was nothing he wouldn't trade for his own single little life. That night, as we reached a clearing in the jungle, the guards appeared. There was a dazzle of light, and they fired. And the men cried and bled and died. He just stood there, watching. His eyes were drunk with it. His eyes said what his words were doing. He was a demon. One of the men grabbed the gun and shot at him. The rest of us cheered and made ready to die ourselves. I tried to forget. But now, the enormity of it, seeing him alive, he has to be punished. Court martial, something I have to turn him in. If he won't die, I want him put away for good.
Elliot, I understand. I do.
I knew you would. No one else ever cared enough. Just you and Dennis. Can you imagine what it did to me? Coming face to face with a man I know is a murderer? A traitor?
Yes. It must have been terrible.
I won't be safe in Houston as long as Barrett Marshall is free. He must realize...
Here, drink this. Try to calm yourself.
You'll help me then.
Has he threatened you?
They say he doesn't remember me. Not yet. But he will. He has to. It can't be otherwise.
Then do nothing for now. Think. And wait.
Wait? For what? For him to prey on me like some jungle bacillus blown across the Pacific? Just knowing he's alive makes me half mad. Can't you see that? Think, Iris, it's what you want. A chance to even the score with the Marshals.
No. I've come to think I was just too hasty in blaming Justin.
But he killed your husband.
Perhaps not. At any rate, I want no part of revenge, and neither should you.
You believe I don't have cause?
You condemned this man for something he didn't do, by your own admission.
I say he is guilty.
He shot no one. It was the guards.
But they were his hands. The man was no amateur in war. He knew what to expect. And up to the last moment, he wore a smiling face. He pretended to be one of us. Until there was only one of us left.
If that's so, he'll live with it the rest of his life. Isn't that punishment enough? You've become so vengeful, Elliot. It's not good. Perhaps it was love for his family, his home. Don't hurt him anymore. Leave him alone.
I can't. I'm afraid to. If I let the traitor go, what does that make me? Would you forgive him?
I don't know. It's really none of my... I wouldn't judge him.
You wouldn't judge him? Oh, my God. What have I done?
What? What did you do to him?
Nothing. I hated him. Every day, every minute, I wished him dead. He pretended to be beyond fear, beyond pain, but I knew he was no better than the rest of us. And now,
Elliot, don't do this. Are you all right? I don't understand this.
How you must love me, and my darling. Oh, I love you. My wife.
No, I'm not your wife. I don't understand what you want or what you're saying. Hello.
Darling, I'm back in Houston. Iris?
It's me, your long-lost husband.
I won't be safe in Houston as long as Barrett Marshall is free. Oh. He must realize...
Here, drink this. Try to calm yourself.
You'll help me then.
Has he threatened you?
They say he doesn't remember me. Yet. But he will. He has to. It can't be otherwise.
Then do nothing for now. Think and wait.
Wait? For what? For him to prey on me like some jungle bacillus blown across the Pacific? Just knowing he's alive makes me half mad. Can't you see that? Think, Iris, it's what you want. A chance to even the score with the Marshals.
No. I've come to think I was just too hasty in blaming Justin.
But he killed your husband.
Perhaps not. At any rate, I want no part of revenge, and neither should you.
You believe I don't have cause?
You condemned this man for something he didn't do by your own admission.
I say he is guilty.
He shot no one. It was the guards.
But they were his hands. The man was no amateur in war. He knew what to expect. And up to the last moment, he wore a smiling face. He pretended to be one of us. Until there was only one of us left.
If that's so, he'll live with it the rest of his life. Isn't that punishment enough? Become so vengeful, Elliot. It's not good. Perhaps it was love for his family, his home. Don't hurt him anymore. Leave him alone.
I can't. I can't. I'm afraid to. If I let the traitor go, what does that make me?
Would you forgive him?
I don't know. It's really none of my... I wouldn't judge him.
You wouldn't judge him? You wouldn't judge him? Oh, my God. Oh, my God. What have I done?
What did you do to him?
Nothing. I hated him. Every day, every minute, I wished him dead. He pretended to be beyond fear, beyond pain, but I knew he was no better than the rest of us.
Ellie, don't do this. Are you all right? I don't understand this.
How you must love me. My darling. Oh, I love you. My wife.
No, I'm not your wife. I don't understand what you want or what you're saying. Hello.
Darling, I'm back in Houston. Iris?
It's me, your long-lost husband.
Still no Elliot, huh?
No. Justin. It occurs to me that, I owe you... an apology.
Oh, well, I just put it on your tab.
I really am sorry. I thought you were with Rena last night.
Oh, some wild stag party, huh?
Why do I bother? That's right, with you popping out of a cake in something brief with sequins.
You have a wonderful imagination.
What is Rena's marrying going to do to you?
It's going to liberate me from a lot of old memories.
I'm serious. You and Rena have spent a lot of time together. That doesn't just fade away. I'm not blind to that.
I want a lawyer. This is a breach of contract. I thought we decided that questions like that were off limits for us.
All right. Just asking. You don't have to answer. I'll play by the rule book, even if we're writing it as we go along.
Mm-hmm. I know it's hard to know what rules we're playing by sometimes, isn't it? I'm a grown-up, Sam. At least I try to be. Sometimes grown-ups have a past that tends to make them humble later. Rena is a part of my past. But she has nothing to do with us.
Fair enough.
Now, the subject of your sordid past we'll save for a rainy day.
Oh, better make that a sun shower. It's sort of low on volume.
Sordid, huh?
Oh, listen, they didn't call me Sam the Swinger for nothing.
I think I'll get back to work.
Yeah, me too. Oh, are you gonna go to the wedding?
Yeah. You?
Well, I wouldn't miss it. After all, she is my cousin. And grown up that I am, I'm dying to see her drop from circulation. I want pictures and notarized copies of all documents.
I bet you do. Listen, there's no sense taking two cars. How about it?
Well, I don't know. What does the rule book say?
Section 1, Article 1, Paragraph A. Say yes and shut up.
Oh. Yes and shut up.
Bye.
Who knows? Maybe I'll catch the bouquet.
What is it? What's wrong?
Oh, I'm fine. It's sweet of you to call, but you shouldn't worry.
Let's not worry. I just miss you. But why so cool? Is something...
That is
I'm sorry, I can't talk right now. Elliot's here.
Dennis?
Oh, he's fine. We both are. You're such a worrier. I'll call you later.
Well, ask him about dinner. I'd like to see him tonight. I'd like to tell him.
Just tell me if he's threatening you.
Dennis, have you made plans for dinner? Elliot would like to see you.
Look, I'll send someone over. Just tell me.
No, no, not at all. I'm sure he'll understand.
Look, I'll call Ryan.
Here, let me talk to him.
Wait a minute. Elliot would like to... What?
Give me the phone.
Wait a minute, what? Yes, all right, darling, bye.
Why did you do that?
Well, a customer came into the gallery. He had to hang up. Really, Elliot, I can't keep pace with you. One moment. Who are you calling? Oh, don't take him away from his work.
Perhaps you're right. Of course you are.
Elliot, I'm tired. Perhaps you should go now. You won't mind.
How were your test results?
Oh, it's good news. Kevin says it's all a false alarm. I'm perfectly fine. In fact, I'm waiting to be released.
Well, that is good news. Well, then you'll be going back to the yacht then.
No, I don't think so. Besides, it may not be back in Houston for several days
yet.
Well,
then how will I know where to reach you?
I don't know. I may go away again. I haven't decided. But I can manage. Please, Elliot, don't concern yourself about me. You have enough on your mind.
I do, yes. You wouldn't... This has been an instructive visit. Physics is no more precise than the science to which we have reduced our... not relationship, our... connection. The carrot and the stick. The promise revoked. I fall for it every time.
I would like a radio phone call placed to my yacht, the Iris, at the Houston Yacht Club. Yes. No, I'm fine. It's just so good to hear your beautiful voice.
In 30 seconds, I'd have that place filled with police. Now, hurry now. Pick up your things and check out. Now, I've sent Jelly over to pick you up. That's why I called. Now, tell me, does Elliot seem suspicious?
No, not suspicious. Angry, I think. Telling he's become impossible. And Ransom carries on in the most unintelligible way. He's very upset to see Barrett Marshall. He told me things I'll try to remember, but Alex, I don't know if I followed half of what he said.
Kate, have you seen Elena?
Well, the wandering boys come home. You know, Max has been grousing since sunup because his best man didn't show. I've been looking at pictures of him growing up. He's going to be mighty glad to see you.
Yeah, or else he's going to bite my head off. Mm. What about Elena? Have you seen her?
They're over at your house now, getting dressed for the wedding. We're going to be leaving shortly for the Bellmans.
No, we'll be ready. But the three of us got to have a talk first.
Ricky, now wait. I had a call from your Aunt Maggie this morning telling me something I already knew. Something about Elena.
You knew, huh? About this job she got singing?
Yes. What I don't hear myself, I'm usually able to sniff out. Max doesn't know. You know, he's had his mind so taken up with the wedding. Don't you think we ought to spare him the words and the worry that this news had caused? Wait until after tonight.
Katie's got to know. Elena can't take this job.
She's 18. Ricky, you can give her brotherly advice, but you can't drag her to her room and lock her in. It's talking, not dragging, that we've got to deal with now. And since it is talking, don't you think maybe you should be the one to do it? And not Max?
I can't help it. I'm a compulsive worker. We all have our little neuroses.
Very happy to believe it. I felt so guilty for not being ill.
Well, at least you had a complete physical.
Managed to ward off Elliot, yes.
Talk about neuroses. He sounds like one for the books.
I wish I understood it. He's really very sweet in a way. Something happened to him. Well, how has Alex been?
Irrepressible, I think, is the word. He's much stronger. He rested well on the trip back. And he misses you.
Let's go.
Oh, thank you.
Sure.
Janie!
Sherry!
Hi!
Excuse me.
Oh, we miss you.
Oh, thanks, Janie. I miss y'all, too.
Listen, as soon as I'm through with this assignment, I'm going to come by and regale you with tales of my adventures. Including, get this, a yacht trip to... Can she take it? St. Croix.
Mm-hmm. Well, we'll keep the coffee pot warm.
You do that. Bye-bye.
Goodbye. Oh. I'm sorry. You frightened me. I don't know why. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry. That young woman you spoke to.
Yes.
Well, I think I met her once. I wanted to speak, but I wasn't sure. Is her name Shelley Lee?
Hmm.
She's a special nurse of some sort, takes private assignments.
Yes, that's her. You've got the right girl. If you run, you can still catch her.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I will.
Rena. They're as different as day and night, and I've got the better man. Max is better in a million ways.
I couldn't agree with you more, baby. Oh. Who are you comparing him to?
Nobody special. I was just thinking that I probably have the best man in the whole state of Texas.
Oh.
Not counting you, of course.
Oh, you make me feel so proud, honey.
Oh, Daddy. Daddy. I feel so scared. I mean, look at all the flowers, the decorations. Everything's ready for the wedding.
Well, it's only natural, honey. After all, marriage is a big step.
Oh, I know, but I've been through this once before. You know, you think a girl would get past the butterflies, wouldn't you?
Oh, now listen, you don't want to get past any matters of the heart, Rena. The butterflies mean you care. You don't know how I've waited for you to find a strong, decent man like Max. I'm so glad that thinking about him makes you feel good on your wedding day. We all have to have something to hold on to, sweetheart. You keep Max Decker first in your heart, and you'll have all the love and happiness you've been searching for that I wanted for you.
I will. Yes, I will, I promise.
I have to do something, Kate. I know how Max will get if I tell him Elena's going to be singing in a honky-tonk, and I know that it'll ruin his wedding day. But I'm caught between a rock and a hard place. If I don't tell him something that's important, he'll be real mad when he finds out, and he's gonna find out. Now, you know what store Max puts in the truth. He'll think that my keeping the truth from him is just as bad as me lying to him.
Now, he's gonna have to come to terms with Elena's 18th birthday. Why, he knows. He knows very well that it's easier to lead a frisky filly than it is to drive one.
Yeah, well, maybe he knows it, but that's just not his style.
Ricky, you talk to Elena. And if you really feel that you've got to tell Max, please wait till after the ceremony. Now, this is a special day in his life. Least we can do is help him over this first hurdle.
Hmm? Yeah, you're right. I guess it can wait till then.
Oh, good boy.
Hey, have you seen... Oh, good, you're here. Ricky, listen, Max wants you to hurry up and get dressed so you can go pick up Reverend Stovall and drive him over to the Bellmans.
All right, but you're coming with me. I'm going to keep you in my sights until I find out just exactly what you've been up to since I've been gone.
I have been doing fine without my big brother sticking his nose into my business
all the time.
I
don't need you. I'm sorry, Daddy. I guess I was, just getting nervous waiting for things to happen around here.
Well, you were never long on sitting still now, were you, honey?
But I'd rather be doing than just sitting any old
day. Well, I would say that getting married is a lot of doing.
You know what I mean. Everybody here is just rushing around and they're doing things. And I'm just sitting like the sacrificial lamb waiting to be thrown into the fire.
Now. Just enjoy it all you can. This is your day, baby. You just take that bell by the handle and ring it as long and hard as you can.
I'll try, Daddy. How are the celebrations for the wedding coming?
Just about done.
Daddy, the flowers are so pretty.
Mm-hmm. Reception's gonna be out here now. See, they got the tent all up, and Maggie is getting set to feed supper to the folks. You know, we're lucky to have us a groom with an aunt who owns a restaurant.
Oh, is this gonna be a big celebration? You know, they're gonna talk about this one for years.
Oh, that's what I want, Maggie. I want a big celebration, Texas style. I want everybody to have fun.
I think that if a girl's gonna do this a second time around, she ought to have a drum and a bugle corps, don't you think? I want everyone to be happy just like I am.
That's my girl.
Did you hire this band for the outing?
Oh, I sure did, honey. You got something special you want them to play?
Well, yeah, I've got one request.
What's that?
When it gets time for Max and I to
dance, our first dance, I'd like them to play a romantic Strauss waltz.
A Strauss waltz? Well, honey, I don't know whether this bunch can handle that or not, but, you know, even if it can, I don't know whether you're going to get Max to dance to something like that. Honey, he is not a trip-the-light fantastic type now. Oh. Besides, you know, Rena, you really better check out a notion like that ahead of time with Max, or he just might not come out of the gate.
Well, now, he's got to dance at his own wedding. Stop worrying. I know that Max won't disappoint me today.
No.
Damn these bow ties, anyway. I'm trying to strangle a man to death.
Now, listen. I don't want you to get this dirty, but dinner's a long way off, so I thought maybe you should eat some milk and cookies, okay?
I can't swallow, Mom. You've tied it too tight.
Yeah, I know how you feel, partner. You know, when you get around women, things starts getting tied down. Sure does, you know. These nooses they put around your neck to the tight corners they push you into.
Now, don't set a bad example for this young man, okay? I think you look beautiful all dressed up. As a matter of fact, I've never seen you look quite so fine.
Well, take a long look, because it's the last time you're going to see it.
Oh, come on, Max. It's not that bad.
Huh.
Anyway, you must be loosening up a little to live in a woman's world, right?
Well, as little as I possibly can. You know me for a long time, Jenny. I ain't no drugstore cowboy. Just not my style.
Just because you put a bow tie on doesn't exactly make you a drugstore cowboy.
Well, that's a start, and in the wrong direction. Next thing you know, she's going to have me wearing one of those shirts with spangles on it.
Max, will you stop? Rita has her hands full trying to tame you, I'll tell you that.
Well, she know better than to try that. At least she ought to.
Will you come on, you man, and on your wedding day?
Hey, Steve, what's that over there? Look. Got a handful. My supper's gonna be late, too. Why don't you see me get everybody ready? It'll be midnight before anybody gets anything to eat.
Are you in a rush to marry me, Uncle Max?
Ooh. Man, a rush? No, man, reach my age, I ain't being married, can't be in a rush, can he?
But since you met Rena, you're in a rush, is that it?
Well, Steve, it's like this, you see, Rena just moves a little bit faster than most folks. When she gets around things, they tend to move a little bit faster, too. They move a little faster, and they get a little bigger and a little better. Like Texas. Right now, I think I'm just moving along at her pace. I think you call it whirlwind.
Okay, everybody. Everyone's ready now. Ready?
You want that?
You want to
be good? All right. Sit down. Come on, let's go. Come on.
We're all losing the
nerves. Come on.
Here we go.
Listen, I think we all sit up.
Yep. Come on, ladies first.
He didn't come into work, huh?
Elliot? No.
Ryan asked me to keep an eye on him. You know, company he keeps, phone calls, any strange behavior. Well, he's dropped completely out of sight. I think I'd call that strange behavior. You think I should call Ryan?
No, we'll see him tonight at the wedding.
Oh.
Besides, Elliot may have just skipped town. I mean, he didn't actually kill Alex, and it's going to be awfully hard to prove that he even tried, so maybe it's just better for everybody if he just left.
Oh, Sam. I think they should lock Elliot up. Even if he does disappear, who doesn't? Who knows when he's going to be back or what he's going to do? When did you start being such an optimist, accepting the easy answers?
Oh, I may be moving that way. Getting Rena out of circulation has softened me up. Of course, I do feel sorry for Max.
Oh, she's not that bad.
Oh, yes, she is. Rena can't stand to see anything at peace or rested. She just gets itchy. Besides, you know that she is never going to settle into sedate married life. You just know that.
She likes to be where the action is.
Action?
Yeah.
I know exactly what kind of action Rena likes. We'll just let good old Max Decker take her off to the ranch and get her out of my hair. And yours. If he can. Come on. We've got a wedding to go to, and I am going to really enjoy this one. I always laugh at weddings, don't you?
Yeah, yeah. As long as it's not mine.
Brian, when Elliot visited me this morning, he told me it was Barrett who betrayed everyone in that prison camp. That Barrett told the guards about their escape plans. And when the men made their break, they ran into an ambush. Now, could that be the truth? Could we be totally wrong about Elliot?
Are you kidding? I don't believe that for a minute. No. No, everything I know about Elliot tells me that he was the one the guards let go. Look, Barrett was shot trying to escape. The guards left him for dead. Elliot got away without a scratch. So what does that tell you?
If there are no other survivors, that makes it rough. It's one man's word against the others. Or worse, if Barrett can't remember exactly what happened, then some people will simply assume that his guilt over his cowardice causes amnesia.
Alex, I brought Elliot into contact with Barrett in the hopes that it would break his nerves. Yes. That by seeing the man he'd sold out and left for dead, that the shock would make him confess. Instead, I'm afraid I just prompted him into coming up with a defense. And he came up with one, he never would have come up with it on his own.
Elliot has always been very clever with stories.
We can't leave it like this. You've got to push. Push hard until he breaks.
Well, great, that sounds fine, but how? I mean, Elliot's not the sort that breaks easily.
Well, tell him I'm alive. That we're after him. No holds barred.
Well, Alex, I might smoke him out, but come on, that's gonna put you right in the center of the target. Hey, we almost lost you once. We can't take any chances, all right?
It depends on how we set it up, what we decide we want to know, how we want to bring him in, and how we want to set the trap.
Darling, please, no. I thought I'd lost you twice. Please, not again. Not that.
Darling, don't worry. I'm not going to get shot a second time. Not a cheap shot like Elliot got. I've changed now. I know who the enemy is. I'm not going to hide out forever.
Please, dearest, let Ryan develop whatever evidence it takes, and you just stay safe a little longer, please. I'm due at the Bellmans for the wedding. Ryan, are you going?
No. Rick is Max's best man. I'll just stand in here for him.
No. Escort Iris. I'm fine now. You two were so careful covering my tracks, nobody knows that the yacht's in Houston, much less that I'm on it. Ryan, go on. Take Iris to me at his wedding. I've never felt safer.
Everything is all right.
It's wonderful, Maggie.
Here they are.
Beth, people are due to arrive any minute.
Yes, another place.
Worry. I'll see that they find their seats and make themselves comfortable, and I'll make sure that the drinks keep flowing.
Yes, please do.
Oh, Vicky, the place just looks wonderful.
Thanks, honey.
Lord knows you didn't have much time to work this particular miracle, did you? How'd you manage?
Oh, I certainly didn't. I only wish Rena hadn't rushed into this so suddenly. If she'd just taken some time.
Now, Vicky, they are in love with each other. It's not like they were 16.
Yeah. Well, she ought to have learned after Kevin that marriage is something you think about before the ceremony. Now, you know I'm right.
Well, just let it go now, Vicky. You know, when I was growing up, people used to say, think long, you think wrong.
Oh, Stryker, honey. If that were true, who'd make any mistakes,
Well.
It's just that I don't think that Max and Rena are the same kind of people. In
fact, I know they're not.
Well, that's never been a prerequisite of a happy marriage or even a happy friendship. Sameness. Matter of fact, it seems to me that we've always liked the pull and tug of things to make life interesting.
How about push comes to shove? Oh, Stryker, this marriage could be the start of the biggest war since... No, I don't know.
Now, listen. No dark thoughts today. This is going to be a heck of a marriage.
That's just what I'm afraid of.
People learn from each other, Vicky. Max can teach Rena so much. Mm-hmm. Share with her.
I expect Rena has a few things to teach Max, too.
Well, I guess she does, but that's the way things ought to be.
Mm-hmm. How do you think she's going to take to ranch life?
Damnation, Vicky. There you go again, just looking at the negative side. Rena's got a lot of good stuff in her. Comes from her mom. You two are a lot alike in spite of all your differences.
Yes, we are.
You know, strong women are bound to have a dust-up now and then. Max and Rena are gonna have theirs, too. But binding everything together is their love. Their love for each other. They'll find themselves a way. Now, no more worrying. Today's a day for happiness.
You're right, honey.
Oh.
Hi, how are
you? Well, here they are. Hello, Kate. Jimmy, how lovely you look. Barry. Hi there, Stevie. Hi, Jim.
Son. Hey, Stryker.
Son, welcome to the family. Welcome. Good to be here. Thank you, ma'am. Yes, excuse me, we'll be right back. It's for the family. Hello, Elena. Hello, honey.
Congratulations.
Ricky, good to see you. Thanks, Reverend, sir. Good to see you. You, sir. We had a rehearsal of this last night, you know, and you were not here. Now, I noticed your absence.
Well, I had to work, Mr. Bellman, or I wouldn't have missed it for the world. You know, getting Max hitched is something I got to see.
I know.
Matter of fact, I got to see it to believe it.
Ricky, do you have any questions about your duties as best man?
No, I don't think so. I guess I'm just here to keep the groom from running in case his nerve breaks.
Now, is there any way to go bad-mouthing your big brother, Artie? There's no way to talk about me. You know, us Deckers supposed to hang together through thick and thin.
Yeah, hang together is just about right.
Well, you hear that, little sister?
Mrs. Wheeler! Oh, Beth, so good to see you again.
You.
Mr. Connors.
Mama, now this is something, isn't it? Mrs. Cook fixing to do it again?
I believe she is, Beth.
Yes. Oh, Rita, I'm so happy for you.
Thank you, but I'd be a lot happier if we could get the show on the road. Entrances always make me nervous, at least this one does.
Doesn't get any easier the second time around, does
no,
it?
No, it sure doesn't. Why haven't
they started? Well, soon enough.
Well, tell Daddy to hurry up.
All right, Miss Impatience, I will.
I have just spoken to your petulant daughter.
Yes.
And she says she is ready for this to start.
Oh.
Well, now listen, we can strike up the music just any time you say.
Well, I think give us about a minute and a half.
Okay, good.
Okay? All right, good. Excuse me. Hey, I am gonna go and get Rena.
Good. I feel like I'm standing around here with two left feet.
All right.
Calm yourself.
About time, buddy.
Yeah. All right. I'm ready.
Yeah, you look like you're ready.
I look like I'm ready, huh? Yeah. All right, I'm ready.
All right.
Are you ready?
Daddy, I've been ready.
Oh, Miss Walker.
How are you? How are you?
Go.
Y'all just about missed the whole shebang.
Well, I'm sorry we're so late. Listen, maybe we better just go in and find a place to stand.
Sam, excuse me. I'll be in a second.
Hey,
Wouldn't be late for your wedding for anything, Rena.
Rena?
Come on, Daddy. I don't want to keep my groom waiting at the altar.
Dearly beloved, we have come together in the presence of God to witness and bless the joining together of this man and this woman in holy matrimony. Marriage is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, deliberately, and in accordance with the purposes for which it was instituted by God. Into this holy union, Rena and Maximilian now come to be joined. If any of you can show just cause why they may not lawfully be married, speak now, or else forever hold your peace. I require you both here in the presence of God that if either of you knows any reason why you may not be united in marriage lawfully and in accordance with God's word, you do now confess it. Bless, O Lord, these rings as a sign of the vows by which this man and this woman have bound themselves to each other. Amen. Repeat after me. I give you this ring, Rena, as a symbol of my vow. And with all that I am and all that I have, I honor you.
I give you this ring, Rena. As a symbol of my vow. And with all that I am and all that I have, I honor you.
Repeat after me. I give you this ring, Maximilian, as a symbol of my vow. And with all that I am and all that I have, I honor you.
I give you this ring, Maximilian, as a symbol of my vow. And with all that I am and all that I have, I honor you.
Now that Rena and Maximilian have given themselves to each other by solemn vows, with the holding of hands, and the giving and receiving of rings, I pronounce that they are husband and wife. Those whom God hath joined together, let no man put asunder. You may kiss the bride.
Let's have a party, all right? Oh, come on. All of it. Well, everybody,
Let's all go outside and enjoy ourselves now. There's a great big feed out there. Compliments of a bank. Kate?
Thank you.
Ginny?
Oh,
Ben? Here, everybody, come on, Ricky. Reverend, come on out now.
Thank you.
Yeah, we got a lot of barbecue out there on the terrace.
Looks like we're both here alone. Why don't we keep each other company during dinner?
Sure. Let's go.
Coming, Sam.
No. You go along and kiss the bride again, and after your third or fourth kiss, or however many Max will let you have without knocking your head off, I'll be along.
You're wrong about that, Sam. I love Max like a brother. Now that Rena has married him, she's more like a sister to me. That was a goodbye kiss you saw, I swear. There'll never be anything between us.
Can't help it. Yeah. I used to roast a whole steer. I'm just too excited to eat any.
Oh, I'm not. Let's have at it. Come on.
Well, I think you need to build up your strength anyway there, big brother. You seem to be having a little trouble getting that ring on Rena's finger.
Well, I was trying. I was, you know, but she kept crooking it on me, and I couldn't get it on there.
That's not true. You were just too cheap to buy one and fit me.
Well, I don't know about that. I think it must have been some kind of a sign, you know? I just couldn't get the thing on there.
Sign my foot! Oh. You talking about?
Oh, what are these two? Sounds like they've been married for years.
I'm surprised I even got him to wear this tie at the wedding. Yeah, I think that maybe we should bronze it and put it in the Cowboy Hall of Fame. What do you think of that? No tie or no tie, I just can't wait for the dancing to start. Mr. Decker will be inviting Mrs. Decker to swirl around the dance floor.
Oh, wait a minute now. What kind of dance are you going to have me do? I don't know any of those fancy rock and roll dances.
I know you, and I know that you're a touch old-fashioned.
Old-fashioned?
So I've asked them to play a romantic Strauss waltz.
Strauss waltz?
Yeah.
Well, that's all right, I guess. Little brother, come here. I need a favor from you.
All right. Since I didn't have time to get you all anything for your wedding, I guess that'll be my wedding.
Hey, you two, now what's going on here?
You're going to find out soon enough. Yes, you will.
Come here, I want another one.
All right.
I'm sorry, Shelley. I'm just not used to being cooped up.
It probably won't be for much longer.
I hope not. All my life, I've worked, been busy. That's what life meant to me.
Well, at least I know what it is you do now. You know, for the longest time, they just told me you were Mr. Wesley. That was it. It was a lot like a story I read once about this sailor who was brought into a Boston hospital during World War II. His ship had apparently been torpedoed or something, but, see, nobody knew for sure because he had lost his memory. Couldn't even remember his name. He had no past that he knew of, and no one else knew it either. That's a little bit the way I felt sitting with you those past few weeks.
I was a sailor once. I didn't have a past either. Left it all behind me.
How do you mean?
Oh, it's not important. It was a long time ago, and those memories will fade one day.
You know, wives and relatives would come to the hospital and to see if this man was their lost sailor. He never was.
You remind me how lucky I am. I had loved ones who waited for me to come back. They were waiting for me. You've been waiting here with me a long time. I'm sorry you had to endure this long night.
Oh, don't be silly. You're the one that's restless, not me. I can stand a little confinement now and again. On a yacht. Besides, you know, you're better company than when you were in the hospital.
Well, at least when I was in a coma, I didn't complain about the confinement. Mm. Why don't we go outside to the fantail and get a little fresh air?
Hey, whoop. You. Now, I'm no security expert, but I've been on enough of these cases to know that when I'm keeping somebody undercover, I don't let him go expose himself for the sake of a little fresh air. Anyway, Ricky and Ryan would have my head if they knew they dreamed I let you loose out there.
Oh, come on. This is ridiculous.
All right. If it's fresh air you want, it's fresh air you get. I'll open a door and a window.
Portal.
Whatever. But that's it. You know, what you need to take your mind off things is a little snack. Why don't you just relax and enjoy the air, and I'll go find the steward.
Sorry, he's on shore leave.
Oh. Well, then, in that case, I guess I'll just have to go scrounge around the old kitchen myself.
Golly.
Right. I do more than just give shots, you know.
Excuse me for a moment, Sam. Gala occasion, isn't it?
Oh, I hope he'll be very happy. Max is such a fine man.
Brian, I tried to keep an eye on Elliot, as you asked, but it's been next to impossible.
Why is that?
He seems to have disappeared. He didn't even report for work today.
I saw him earlier today at the hospital. He seemed very overwrought, almost... Well, I hate to say this, but mad.
I think that little meeting that you set up between he and Marin really shook him up.
But he didn't even come to work afterwards, though, huh? It's pretty odd.
Do you think he decided to leave town?
No, I don't think so. Even if he did, I couldn't just leave it like that. Elliot's too much of a threat. He could always come back.
Even if he didn't come back for Alex, he could always come back for Merritt next.
Right. Perhaps we could leave her.
Yeah, I don't like the idea of leaving Alex alone, especially with Elliot on the loose.
I wonder if I may come with you. See Alex. I'd like to tell him how much I'm sorry for blaming him for all those months. My father's death. Do you think he'd see me?
I'm so just me.
My heartache troubles are...
Ta-da! Found some champagne and some munchies. And I'm gonna give you a good neck rub to help you relax.
Well, that shouldn't hurt.
No.
In the future, I hope to find time to enjoy champagne. I mean to find the time. At any rate, it's nice to be indulged.
Why not? Oh, here. You go over, sit down, take your robe off, and I'll see about that neck rub now.
Yourself to some champagne.
Thanks.
He is alive. Alex is alive.
Gala occasion, isn't it?
Oh, I hope he'll be very happy. Max is such a fine man.
Brian, I tried to keep an eye on Elliot, as you asked, but it's been next to impossible.
Why is that?
He seems to have disappeared. He didn't even report for work today.
I saw him earlier today. At the hospital. He seemed very overwrought, almost... Well, I hate to say this, but mad.
I think that little meeting that you set up between he and Marin really shook him up.
But he didn't even come to work afterwards, though, huh? It's pretty odd.
Do you think he decided to leave town?
No, I don't think so. Even if he did, I could just leave it like that. Elliot's too much of a threat. He could always come back.
Even if he didn't come back for Alex, he could always come back for Merritt next.
Right. Perhaps we could leave
her. Yeah, I don't like the idea of leaving Alex alone, especially with Elliot on the loose.
I wonder if I may come with you. See Alex, I'd like to tell him how much I'm sorry for blaming him for all those months, for my father's death. Do you think he'd see me?
Wheeler is alive.
Is that a real Texas style letter?
It's vintage Rainer, start to finish. Nothing else like it this side of the Rio Grande.
Well, I'll just step right up here, Justin.
Okay, maybe we should put up more lights.
I can see well enough.
I'll go in and tell Alex you're here. Darling, we're back.
Did you miss me? Well, no, I suppose not. You seem to have found a fine way of passing the time.
Iris.
Champagne and caviar, a back rub.
Well, special patient, you know, who was getting very restless.
And missing you.
Shelley, how was everything, quiet?
Yeah. Things were so dull, Alex almost wandered out on the fantail to break the boredom.
Oh, for a while there, I was afraid she was going to tie me to the bunk.
Well, you know, the champagne seemed like a better idea.
Well, we're back now, and none too soon, if you ask me.
Mrs. Wheeler.
I'm quite capable of entertaining my own husband. Thank you. So if you don't mind.
If you gentlemen will excuse me.
Thank you for the back rub, Shelley.
Anytime.
Shelley. Mm-hmm. You all right?
Never better. How could that woman possibly think that of me? After all I've done for her, I go into restaurants, I pour drinks all over, I save her from her loony ex-husband. All right, Shelley, just take 10 deep breaths. 1, 2. Who's there?
Don't you worry about the ranch while you're on your honeymoon. Steve and I'll take good care of the horses for you, right, won't we, Steve?
Yes, sir.
You sure you're mine now?
Hell no. I feel like you're the ones doing me a favor. It makes me feel useful for a change. You just enjoy your trip. And remember, I was taking care of the place when you and Justin were just kids.
Oh. Okay, tell me, where are you two going, or is it a big, deep, dark secret?
Well, as a matter of fact...
It is a deep, dark secret. It happened to be the best fishing spot on the Medina River. And the only way I'm taking Rena along is she promises not to tell anyone where it is.
Now, wait a second.
Well, I told you it was up in the hill country.
Well, yes, honey, but I was kind of figuring that maybe it was this, you know, cozy little hotel. With all
You were you?
Yeah.
Well, there ain't no hotels where we're going, honey. But, I know how to pitch a tent, and they've got sleeping bags and everything. Come on, be nice and cozy.
I married this man. Do you realize I married this man?
Oh, on second thought, maybe it'd be better we stay tonight in a hotel in Houston. How about that?
I think so, Max.
Yeah, I think so, too. Maybe we can head north in the morning, all right?
Gee, I wish I could go. I've never been camping, ever. But I know how to tend a fire and toast marshmallows so they don't burn.
Well, honey, I tell you what, I think this time Uncle Max would like to be alone with his new bride, okay? Kate!
Stevie, those toasted marshmallows, they sound real good, but I think your mother's right this time.
You ready to go?
Hey.
We'll be along directly.
Yeah, I can take you camping, too, you know.
You would?
Yeah, but not this time. We don't want to horn in on a honeymoon fishing trip, do we?
A honeymoon fishing trip, I mean. Max, honestly.
Honey, come on. You're going to love it, I guarantee.
Can I have that in writing?
In writing. She wants it in writing. You believe that? You want it? What do you want in writing? Everything? Everything? I got to sign away my life in writing?
Daddy.
I'm going to be writing.
Daddy, I want this in writing.
What more do you want in writing now, honey? You've already got yourself a marriage license.
And a fishing license.
Oh, I can't imagine what else we
Well, aren't there guarantees in life? Didn't your daddy ever teach you that? You're not going to get that right.
That doesn't mean she doesn't want them.
You're right there.
Oh, I thought you said that we were ready.
We are.
Where's Jeb?
He's with Elena. But if you're ready, we're ready. Steve?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, I guess I'll have to say goodnight for now. Listen, I'll talk to you about that again tomorrow.
Hey. Okay. All right.
Thank you.
Good to see you. Goodbye, Barrett. Hey, good to have you with us. Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you.
Bye-bye, big fella.
Bye.
Safe trip, all.
Okay.
Good night, honey. Well.
Daddy.
What?
Talk to Kate about it.
Now, you see what this person is like here, Max? You cannot keep a secret from her. If you do, she'll worm it out of you one way or another.
That's right, Daddy. So you just might as well spill it out and tell me what you and Kate were bickering about.
Well...
I know when you're negotiating, Daddy.
If you know that much, then you know that we were getting around to making a deal about a little wedding present for you from your mama and me.
Oh... Daddy, what is it?
No, well, you might not get it, because Kate might drive too hard a bargain.
You know something? I mean, you could have been a horse thief if you hadn't been such a good lawyer. Come on now, tell me what it is.
We want Kate to let us buy some land around that cabin. And I wanted to give it to you for a wedding present, so that you'll have a spread of your own. Now, what do you think of that?
There was absolutely no reason for you to have treated Shelley that way. I will not tolerate such rudeness, especially after all she's done for us.
I'm sorry, darling. I didn't mean to be rude. I just thought you'd like to see your visitor more privately.
Visitor?
May I come in, Alex?
Justin.
I want to apologize. I've wanted to apologize from the moment that they took you to the hospital. I went there to thank you. Thank you for defending me in spite of all I'd said.
that I had done. When they told me that you were dead, I didn't think I'd ever have another chance to tell you how sorry I was for blaming you, for driving my father to suicide, hating you for something that you didn't do. Alex, will you forgive me? I know it seems a bit presumptuous to think that all that I've done can be washed away with a few words of an apology. All that I've done can be changed by just... Thanks anyway. I'll be going now.
Oh, Daddy, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. It was so wonderful.
Well, now listen, I'm not sure that Max agrees with all this. This was supposed to be a present for both of you, you know, honey. How about it, Max? Would you agree to accept the land as a wedding present?
I don't know, Stripe.
Honey, don't you remember that time that we had dinner out at the cabin and you were saying how much you'd love to have a place of your own?
I meant I'd like to buy a place of my own, not have it given to me. Stryker, I appreciate your generosity, but accepting land, I can't do it. Honey, I told you, after we got married, we're gonna live on Max Decker's money, not yours, not your daddy's. I hope you understand, old friend.
Well, I don't. If we don't have a place to stay, then where are we gonna stay? I mean, do you want to live in my house in Houston?
There's nothing wrong with that little cabin, is there?
Honey, he is your husband. What he says goes.
Honey... I aim to get a bigger place someday, but I want to do it my way. By going down to the Marshall County Bank and getting a loan and paying for what we get. Our home is my responsibility, not your daddy's.
I understand, Max. You're right, Annie.
Well, sounds like the music stopped. I guess Elena must have wore out the band on the dance floor, too. Well, I better go round her up so we can get started on our honeymoon. Okay.
Daddy.
Now, listen, I know that look.
Daddy.
You have got one stubborn husband,
honey,
there. And if I were you, honey, I wouldn't...
around that thick mule head of his. Now, don't you worry. I want us to have that spread. I'm going to find a way around him. Just need to have a little time. Oh, that was fun, wasn't it, Jeff?
For whose feet?
For mine. I just love doing the cotton eye joke.
That's because you don't care whose feet you walk all over.
Oh,
mine are killing me right now.
Come on, I'm not such a bad dancer. Hey, maybe they'll give us an encore, you think?
No, I don't think so. I think enough's enough. I think...
Enough is right. It's time to get home.
Why?
Well, because it's late.
Well, I can tell time, but that has nothing to do with whether I stay or not. I mean, who says that Jeb and I have to go?
I say... I'm beat.
So, let's go.
Some friend that you...
Hey, wait up.
I'm the best friend that you've
ever had. Get in here, sitting there all by lonesome. I'm waiting for you. I'm sorry, I'm all danced out. Hey, lighten up, that's a joke, little brother.
Look, I put this off long enough. But I can't let you go off on your honeymoon without saying...
Excuse me, I'm going to go find...
Uh-uh, you're staying right here.
Don't you look at me.
Please.
Excuse me, I'm going to get the car.
What's going on here?
Well, nothing much. Except that I thought you might like to know what our little sister's planning on doing the minute you get out of town.
Justin, wait.
It's all right, Alex. I understand. If you don't want to speak to me.
If I didn't speak, it was only because I was so touched by what you were saying. Not because I hold any grudges. Please. Consider your apology accepted. Ryan, Iris, I think we have something to celebrate.
That's right. New friend.
And a new understanding. Iris, would you pour some champagne?
Of course.
If you only knew how often I wanted to talk to you about Mike, I loved your dad like a brother. I truly did.
Champagne for everyone but you, Mr. Wheeler. You are going to have some orange juice, like it or not.
Here, I'll help you.
You don't.
All right. Thank you.
And for you, Iris.
Thank you.
A toast to reconciliation.
Absolutely.
Here.
I feel as though a shadow were lifted from my life.
And mine.
Oh, I am so glad for both of you.
Listen, if you'll all excuse me, I'm just going to see where Shelley's disappeared to. I'll be right back.
In all honesty, I'll have to admit that I should have supported your dad. When he came to me that night, however, this beautiful woman had just come back into my life, and I wasn't thinking of the help that an old friend needed from me. I don't know what to say, but I regret...
I have something to say. My father called me when I was in Europe, the night that he died. He needed help. He needed someone to talk to. You, at that time, had someone you were very much in love with on your mind. Me, I just had a race, a lousy race that I had to win to retain the title. That's what kept me from being able to hear his final plea for help.
Oh, Justin.
I was the one that failed my father, but I blamed you. It was easier than accepting my own guilt, Alex.
To the memory of Mike, may he rest in peace and forgive us all.
Thank you.
Shelley? Shelley! Hey, Shelley! Shelley, where are you?
I'll be right there. Hang on. Boy, the other side of that boat is so dark. Is that for me? Thank you.
So what were you doing on the other side?
I thought I heard somebody.
And why were you there?
To see if I was right or not.
You shouldn't have done that.
What did you expect me to do?
You should have called me.
I thought it might be my imagination. And in case you've forgotten, I've already been embarrassed once this evening. I didn't much feel like making a fool out of myself again coming to get you if it was a false alarm. So I went to see for myself.
And what happened?
Well, sure enough, there was nobody there. Unless you count the stars or the waves or the seagulls.
That means there was nothing to see. That doesn't mean there was nothing there. is that?
I don't know.
Go back to the cabin.
No, Ryan.
I said get inside now.
Why do you have to act like I'm trying to sneak something past Max?
Because you are.
I am not.
Yeah, well, you didn't tell him.
So what?
So what are you waiting for?
I am waiting for the same thing that you were waiting for. I didn't want to cause a scene in the middle of his wedding.
The wedding's over. I'm listening.
We could have postponed this till after his honeymoon.
Sure, Elena, if you'll postpone your plans till then.
What plans? I said, what plans, Elena?
I'm quitting school.
The hell you are.
You cannot stop me.
You want to bet? You're not quitting school, and that's that. Not as long as you're living under my roof.
Well, then maybe I won't be under your roof.
Oh, yeah? And just where are you going to run off to? Not your Aunt Maggie's, I can tell you that.
No, you're right, not my Aunt Maggie's, because she would be all over me just the way you and Ricky always are. But I'm going to go into Houston and find me a place of my own because I've got a job of my own, and you can't do anything about it, Max, because I'm 18. There, are you satisfied?
Not so fast, little lady.
Let go of me, Max.
No.
I said let go
of
me.
I got something I want to say to you.
Max. Max, what's going on here?
I'm sorry to be having a family argument in front of you and your folks, but Elena here is the one who's responsible. Or should I say irresponsible?
Now, honey, what's the matter?
Oh, nothing much. She just wants to quit school and get herself a job in Houston.
Yeah, a job singing in a sleazy bar.
In a bar? Not only that, she was going to duck out when I had my back turned. As soon as Rena and I got in the car, is that how it was going to be, Elena?
What if it was?
Well, you can have a long wait, honey. Because I'm not going anywhere now.
Max?
I'm not going anywhere if she's going to duck out behind my back.
Well, maybe she's not. Honey. Honey, you wouldn't want to spoil our honeymoon now, would you?
No, I don't.
So why don't you just wait here until Max and I get back from our honeymoon? Then we can all sit back and we can talk about this thing rationally.
Hmm? Yeah, but Max doesn't talk about anything rationally, and neither does Ricky.
Well, what if they agree? Will you agree to stay?
Look, my...
Honey, what harm could it do?
My job just won't wait, Rena. Look, this could be the chance of a lifetime. I mean, this is a chance for me to make a whole new start, and Max just wants to spoil everything for me.
Oh, no, no, honey. He just doesn't agree with the way you're going about this, that's all.
Yeah, well, he has no idea what makes me happy.
His heart is in the right place, though. Oh, come on, honey, stay here, and we can talk about it afterwards. Please? Honey, please.
Oh, Rena, there's just nothing to talk about. Look, Max just has nothing to say about what I do anymore because I'm 18. And I want to be self-supporting, so what I do with my life is just nobody's business. Busybody.
Lena, I'm warning you. You walk out of my house now and you're not coming back. Not after you drag the streets of Houston. You understand me? Elena, I said, do you understand?
Max, I don't think it's you that understands. I don't think you get it, Max. I don't care if I ever go back to that ranch. I hate that ranch. And I hate the way you're always preaching to me, and I'm just tired of it. You think you're so smart all the time, don't you? But you haven't done one single important thing in your life, Max. And you're boring, Max Decker. You make me sick. Oh. Rena, I don't know how you could take him. I just hope you know what you're getting yourself into.
Now you shut your mouth!
No, because it isn't me that started it! Look, I'm really sorry that... But I disrupted your whole household and everything. And I didn't mean to spoil your wedding or your honeymoon. But my life is important to me, too. And I'm not going to ruin it. I'll be in the car.
Max, Max, it's not the way. Now you trust me in this one.
Steve.
Take him up to bed. Good night, Grandma.
Good night, Barry.
I'll be up in a minute.
Okay.
Oh. Whew. Your feet hurt? You didn't do much dancing.
Oh, these shoes. Why does it always feel so good to take your shoes off?
Oh, are you sure those fit?
What are you doing?
Well, I'm waiting for Elena and Jeb.
Is this going to be an all-night vigil? Is that why you're making coffee?
No. Maybe. I just knew I couldn't rest until I got here, so I thought I'd just make me some coffee.
Kate, I'm surprised at you. I thought you trusted Jeb.
I do.
Well, what are you doing staying up all night playing chaperone, then?
That's not what I'm doing.
It's just you look so worried.
Well, I am worried about what's going to happen when Max finds out that Elena's fixing to get herself a job in Houston.
Ooh, Max will raise the roof.
Yeah, he'll be so unreasonable.
Well, Max is very conventional. He has such old virtues.
And Elena doesn't have any at all?
Kate, Max has set very high standards for Elena.
Oh, they don't fit her any more than those shoes fit you. You know, it's difficult to set standards for someone else and expect them to live up to it. And Max doesn't know the difference.
Trust you? It's her I don't trust. I gotta show her that she's not too big for me to handle.
Whoa, Max, cool down. Now, she is not going anywhere.
Well, she means to as soon as I leave town.
Well, there's nothing you can do about it.
You want to bet there isn't?
Not legally. She's 18. That means she's an adult. There's a law that says you can't stop her. If she wants to leave home or get a job, support herself, she's old enough.
I don't care about the law. She's just a little girl. She's my baby sister, and I don't want her out there running around Houston.
She can sue you if you stop her, or even try.
Are you trying to tell me there's nothing I can do about it?
I'm not trying to tell you. I'm telling you. Now, listen. You might just as well go on your honeymoon, son.
Honey, Daddy's right.
Well, he may be right about the law, but he's not right about me. I'm not going anywhere.
Oh, Max, why not, honey?
Honey, I couldn't enjoy myself. I'd be as nervous as a cat in a room full of rocking chairs. I wouldn't be able to fish or relax or do nothing. Look how keyed up I am now.
Now, look, Max, come on. Let's have a drink.
Yeah, that's what I need. I need a drink.
Come on.
Jeb, what about you?
Well, you heard what your father just said. There's nothing anybody's going to do to stop her.
Jeff, there is something that somebody can do to make Max feel a little easier. I mean, about going on his honeymoon. I do want a honeymoon, Jeff.
I would like to see you have a honeymoon, but I don't know what I can do.
Well, honey, maybe if you were willing to be personally responsible for Elena until we got back from our honeymoon. You know, take care of her, make sure she doesn't get any trouble, things like that. I think that if you would do that, that he'd be able to enjoy himself on his honeymoon. It would be the best wedding present that anyone could give me, honest. Besides, I think you owe me a little cooperation from New Year's Eve, right?
Yes. I have not forgotten about that.
Good. And what do you say? You do it?
Okay. I will give it my best shot.
All right, that's all I need. Thanks.
All right,
how you feeling, honey?
Well, calmer anyhow.
But not any happier.
Well, you will in a minute. Jeb's got some news to tell you.
The only news I want to hear is that Elena's staying home.
Well, it's pretty close, honey. Jeb, tell him.
Max, I think there's a way you can go on your honeymoon after all.
No, I wouldn't enjoy it.
Well, now, wait a minute. What if there was somebody that was going to be personally responsible for her? I mean, look after her day and night.
Who?
Me. I will do that. I will keep as tight a leash on her as you would if you were there yourself.
What do you say, Annie?
Till I get back?
You got my word. Deal?
Oh, no.
Honey, honey, say yes.
Please. It's a deal.
Oh, I'm so happy.
Well, I'm not. The only reason I'm doing it is because there's nothing I can do to stop
her. Oh, and because you know she will be in such good hands.
And because the white bass only run once a year. Thanks, Jim.
Have a happy honeymoon.
Huh? Yeah.
Oh, yes.
Remember when your dad brought home that white elephant from India because apparently he defended some Raja?
You couldn't believe my grandmother said.
Oh, I could just imagine.
She told my daddy, what am I supposed to feed that thing?
That was said with $20 bills.
Shelley, why don't you go inside?
I was too mad at Iris.
Well, how about now? Come on. Come on.
All right.
Here we are.
Oh.
Well, welcome back. Is there anything wrong outside? You were gone quite a long time.
Well, Shelley thought she heard someone, but we didn't run across anything suspicious.
Do you think it could have been Elliot?
Yes, it could have been.
Oh, how can that be?
You say he came to visit you in the hospital this morning, right?
Yes.
And he didn't go to work today, right?
That's right.
Then he could have followed both of you here.
Well, I didn't see anyone. But Shelley has had professional training. Perhaps you saw something I didn't.
If Elliot was following us, I didn't notice anything either. But thank you for the compliment.
There's been some speculation around the office that he left town.
Well, that's easily taken care of. Let's call him.
All right. Hello. Elliot. Justin, I hope I didn't wake you.
Well,
I was just concerned. You didn't report for work today. I thought you may have been ill.
Well, you did wake me. I've been sleeping most of the day. Some bug, flu, perhaps. You know how debilitating that can be.
Yes, yes, of course, I understand.
Well, I appreciate your concern, but I assure you by tomorrow, everything will be fine.
All right, Elliot, thank you. Bye. False alarm.
Maybe. Maybe not. Either way, looks like we're gonna have to make some plans how to resolve this situation.
All right, here we go, number 8. Sure, in the hill country on the Medina River, but
I guess it'll do for tonight.
Where are you?
I'm burning.
What?
I got so excited, I think I got the wrong key.
Oh, Max!
I'll be right back. Come on.
If you're lucky.
Hey, what is this? Why the crying? Oh, it is something. Rena. Whatever else we've been to each other, we've always been honest. Come on, tell me. What is it?
I...
I feel guilty. No, it's not what you think. It's not like that. I mean, I don't think that I've committed a crime or anything. I just feel like a little girl who's been very, very bad. And instead of being punished, somebody's given me the most wonderful gift in the whole world.
Well, I am very good.
Yes, you're very good. Do you know that I'd almost forgotten what it felt like to be loved? I mean, even hypothetically. Even for just tonight, do you understand?
I've always understood you, Rita.
Oh, shh. We have wasted so much time. Do you realize that? The bitchery, the chasing around. Honey.
It's the hunt, my dear. You can't have the catch without the chase.
Oh, I'm worn out with chasing around. I'm tired. Can't we just give up steeplechase for a while and be nice to each other? That's all I really want.
Wouldn't change anything, Rena. Sooner or later, we'd be back chasing our tails again. Tomorrow, maybe the next day.
No.
You and that devious little mind, sooner or later, would cross us up.
Honey, you don't have to worry about that. You always outmaneuvered me, don't you remember that? You don't have to worry about the future. I mean it.
Why not? Let's stop all this chasing.
I ran so fast, I got blisters on my feet. All right. Whew. All right, hallelujah. I tell you, I just hope that Jeb Hampton knows what he's doing. All right, here we go.
Max Decker.
What?
I'm your bride. Now, you come over here right this second, and you start carrying me across the threshold like you're supposed to.
Are you sure that's what you want?
No, that's what I want,
though. That's what the lady wants. That's what she's gonna get. Here. Here you go. Now, I don't know why you women think this is so romantic, but all right. Hey, you know, Mrs. Decker, feel any more like a wife now?
What a way to start a honeymoon.
I thought I was being very obliging.
You were.
Excuse me while I take care of some business now.
Hey, wait a minute. Who are you calling?
I'm calling another woman.
What?
Yes, Elena.
Oh, Max, what? No, you
No, wait a minute.
I want you to put this phone down right away. Now, listen. I want you to start paying a little attention to Rena tonight and showing a little confidence in Jeb. You hear?
You really think she's going to be all right?
Yeah. A little stubborn, darling.
I guess you didn't realize what a crazy family you were marrying into.
Oh, I don't know. Not any crazier than the Bellmans. Honey?
Uh-huh?
I wonder what our children look like.
What do you say we start finding out right now, huh?